Hey, buds below. Up is where to grow. Up with which below.
When I left Camelot, I went to do a musical with Bob Preston called We Take the Town, which closed in Philadelphia. Before I left, Bud Whitney, Alan J. Lerner's assistant, called me on the telephone. John, he said, there's a wonderful role in this play that Alan J. Lerner is working on. It's about a young girl who has psychic powers, who can tell what's going to happen in the future, and also has a past. She's a very cosmopolitan, sophisticated, gorgeous lady who's in love with this romantic, handsome guy. And Alan has you penciled in for that guy, and he has a wonderful number. I said, that's great. So I went out on the road. Show closed in Philadelphia with Bob Preston, We Take the Town. Came back to New York feeling bad. Read in the New York Times that Lerner was looking for a John Cullum type to play this role. I said, what in the world are they? I called up Bud. I said, what in the hell is going on here? I said, you're looking for a John Cullum type. You got John Cullum. What's going on? He said, John, I'm sorry, but Alan doesn't think you can handle the humor of that role. And so I said, okay. So they kept reading me for the role. And then they kept putting it off and putting it off. And then they called me up and said, John, would you consider reading for the leading role? They had hired this European actor, a very fine actor. And then they had flown to Europe and found out that he couldn't sing a note. And so they came back and they were looking for somebody else. This was before Louis came into the picture. So they made me go to a linguist and learn to speak with a Viennese accent because they did not think that a psychiatrist could speak English without a Viennese accent. I learned to speak with a Viennese accent and it stood me in very good stead when I played the King of Siam because I used that accent for everything from then on. But I auditioned for the lead, and I would audition for the character of the guy from the past, and they kept putting it off, and then I got a cold. I was being considered to play the Carrasco in Man of La Mancha at Goodspeed, and I was also had an offer to do a nice role in the movie of Hawaii, and I was working on my own Hamlet that I was doing in Milwaukee. And I got this call and say, we want you to come up and sing. I said, I'm not coming. I'm not reading anymore. I said, you've seen me plenty of times. I said, and they said, but Bobby Lewis hadn't seen you that much. And they have some new backers. Please, John, come up. You don't have to sing. You don't have to read or anything. I said, well, I'm going to be uptown anyway. I have to go and see Albie Marbot. I said, okay. So I went up and I went to the theater and I strode around on the stage. Didn't say a word, and then I stopped, and Bobby Lewis said, well, John, said, aren't you going to say anything? I said, no. I said, I don't want to ruin the wonderful, wonderful impression that I've made on you, the last 12 auditions that I've done for you. And so I left the stage and made a joke out of it. But I said to the people, the stage manager, I said, I have to hear by 9 o'clock tonight. If I don't hear from you by 9 o'clock, I'm going to take the movie Hawaii. They didn't call. I took the movie Hawaii. The telephone rang, and it was Bud Whitney from Boston. And he started talking about, John, you have to come to Boston. I said, I am not going to come. I said, I've been jerked around enough. And I said, no, you've got to. They're serious. I said, what's wrong? And I mentioned the actor who was playing the role that I was supposed to play. And he said, no, it's not him. It's Louis Jordan, the lead. I said, the lead? I said, well, okay. So I jumped on the plane, went to
to Boston.
I learned the entire script in a hotel room. And at night, I would go and sit in the bathroom while my wife would try to get some sleep, learning the lyrics of the songs and working with Bobby Lewis just one-on-one. Never saw the company. And I had 5 days to learn the entire script.